Hi there, I'm Chihiro from Japan. Welcome back to the program. Let's learn a life lesson from a story together. Thanks for subscribing to my channel. Let's get started then. The story I'm going to tell you is about an episode that happened at a child care facility in Japan. Today's story is different from the usual, but I hope you feel something from this story. A 4-year-old boy came to the facility. The reason why he came was that he lost both his mother and father in a traffic accident. At first, his relatives and the people around him took care of the boy, but it didn't last long. As it turned out to be difficult for people around him to continue caring for him, they decided to send him to the facility. There are many children in the facility who have lost their families. They study and learn various things about how to live in society. The facility gives the children pocket money to teach them how to save and spend money as a part of their education. The children receive a small amount of money for New Year's and their birthdays. The children were very happy when they received pocket money. They bought their favorite dolls or plastic models and played happily. However, the 4-year-old boy did not buy anything. The boy didn't show any signs to buy what he wants, no matter how much time passes. The worried teacher asked, "Why don't you buy anything? Let's go shopping together." But the boy wouldn't buy anything. Then the boy said these words, "I won't buy anything. I'm saving money to buy my mom and dad." That's what he said. What do you think? Even if he saves as much money as he can, unfortunately, he cannot buy his parents. They will never come back. The teachers wondered if they should tell him the truth, but when they saw the boy, they couldn't say anything. They were so full of emotions seeing the boy who was enduring, not buying anything he wanted, while everyone else was buying things they wanted. So, they couldn't say anything. After a few years has passed, the boy suddenly ran into the staff room, full of energy and excitement. He said, "Teacher, I'll be buying my parents this August. So can you please give me the money I've entrusted to you?" Receiving the total amount of 17,000 yen, which the boy had saved up over the years, the boy joyfully ran out of the staff room. Around an hour and a half later, the boy returned to the staff room, holding a paper-wrapped package in his hand. Opening the package, the teachers found an unmarked memorial tablet, which is called oihai in Japanese. Oihai is a wooden tag used to remember the deceased. When someone passes away, people write their name, the date of passing, and their age. The boy carefully carried the unmarked oihai back home, treasuring it dearly. He then said, "I remember when my parents died. The old lady next door told me, It's sad and lonely, isn't it? I'm all alone too. Look over there. There's my husband. And she showed me the oihai. So this oihai is my parents. With a happy face, he embraced the oihai. The teachers couldn't hold back their tears as they witnessed the boy's happiness. The boy said that he wanted to buy his parents, meaning the memorial tablets for his deceased father and mother. Even though their form may have changed into wooden tablets, the presence of his father and mother will always be with him. How much courage their existence gave the boy. Even if their form has changed, he can still feel the souls of his parents through the memorial tablets. Thanks to the tablets, the boy could sense his parents close to him. Thus, memorial tablets and teachings of Buddhism connect us with our ancestors and also give us the energy to turn difficult situations into hope for life. We will all experience difficult and painful times, but we cannot just grieve and give up on life. Like this boy, we must eventually face forward and move forward. At the age of only 4 years old, when he would have wanted to rely on his parents the most, the boy lost both of them at the same time. Yet, even this boy is trying his best to accept reality and move forward. He still loves and thinks of his parents who are no longer with him. Doesn't it make your heart swell with emotion? In the teachings of Buddhism, there is a concept of cultivating the ability to endure a little bit, even in difficult and painful situations. And remember, no matter what happens, the Buddha always encourages and supports us. In our daily lives, we all face many challenges and difficulties. But remember, the Buddha is always by our side, giving us the strength to endure. As we face these challenges, we must slowly cultivate the ability to endure and continue on our life journey. It is true that we are born alone and die alone. However, we should be grateful for having parents by our side during our life. The 4-year-old boy lost both of his parents at the beginning of his life journey. Although his parents passed away early, I believe he will still have a happy life in the future. I sincerely hope for his happiness, and I believe the Buddha is always watching over him. This story has made me reflect on my life and how I live it. I think I need to try harder and do better. When the boy returned with the memorial tablet, he looked very happy and had a smile on his face. Yes, that is the important part. We don't smile because we are happy. We are happy because we can smile. Even though buying a memorial tablet won't bring the boy's parents back, he still smiles. At the age of only 4 years old, he instinctively understands this. Perhaps this is the nature of humanity. Hopefully this video is helpful to you. Well, that's about it for today's episode. How was it? I hope your life shines even brighter. Let's talk about life, time, Buddhism, love, and many other things together in the following episode. Please subscribe to our channel. Have a great time and keep on smiling. Thank you for listening till the end. See you soon.